Ladies and gentlemen, you are going to learn my top 15 MacBook life hacks that will definitely change your lives. So let's dive straight into it, shall we? Alright. Drag something on your MacBook, you usually hover the mouse on that and start dragging it. But the moment you stop dragging, it's gone back. This is really annoying. So all we have to do is go to System Preferences, then to this blue accessibility guy, scroll down to find pointer control and click on trackpad. Then enable dragging and make sure you have three finger drag selected here. Now hover the mouse to the item you want to drag and start dragging with three fingers. Now even when you stop dragging, that item is going to be in its place and you can continue dragging from there. Do you delete letter by letter while typing? Well, this next keyboard shortcut is going to save you a ton of time and energy. Simply, if you use option along with the delete key, it will delete the whole word before the cursor. Is your MacBook becoming slower day by day? This could be because the cache is taking up too much memory of your Mac. You can make your MacBook faster just by pressing Shift plus Command plus G while in Finder and type this and hit return. Delete all these junk files and your Mac should be a lot more responsive than before. If you open a tab regularly, your email page for example, you can simply right click on that and pin that tab. So you won't have to open that page again and again while using Safari. Also, I've seen some guys saving a PDF file on Safari by first printing it and select save as PDF from here. But a simple hack for this is instead of Command plus P for printing it, hit Command plus S and it will save that PDF directly. Speaking about PDF, did you know that you can select multiple images or PDFs? Right click and from quick actions, convert them into a single PDF file by selecting Create PDF here. This is why I love using Mac so much. And by the way, if you are enjoying, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. If you are browsing through something or reading a book and you want a line or paragraph to be remembered for quick reference, all you have to do is select the text, right click from services at the bottom, click on make new sticky note. And now you can type this somewhere else or even copy paste without having to shift between apps. I guarantee you didn't know this. In the Notes app, it becomes quite difficult to highlight something. All you can do is make it bold or underline for that, right? Not really. Select the text you want to highlight and press Shift Command plus C. Now you can change the color of the text you want to highlight. How cool is that? And the best part is, although this is not yet possible to do on iPhones, it will still apply the color on your iPhone that you have changed on your Mac. With multiple applications running on your Mac, it's difficult to concentrate on the app you're working on. So a quick shortcut to remember here is Shift plus Command plus H. This will hide all the applications other than the application in focus. Similarly, when you have multiple windows open for an application, it becomes difficult to cycle through them. But instead, you use Command plus this tilde key to quickly cycle between windows of the same app. Likewise, to make your workspace more organized, you can create multiple desktops by either swiping up with four fingers or use Control plus up key and add as many desktops as you like. But this is something most of us know. Now, fun fact here is you can have different wallpapers on your desktops to make it much more cooler. Also, when you have two or three desktops, you can simply drag an app to the corner until it ends up to the next desktop or drag and drop from here if you have multiple desktops. Now you can swipe left and right with four fingers to surf between desktops, but I'd prefer using Tab Switcher. This will not only get you to some other desktop, but also land you on your specific app. Give it a try, it makes working a lot better. This next hack is also going to be something new. Open an image in preview, select markup, and from this box, select Smart Lasso. What you can do is select an area it will automatically detect the corners and hit Command plus K to crop it. This is how you can crop something from an image on your Mac. This is a cool life hack for almost everyone. When typing something, do this instead. Press the FN key 2 times and you can start dictating what you wanted to type. Really helpful when in meetings or lectures, trust me.
I've got 15 MacBook hacks for you in this video. See, it's that easy.
Lastly, if you are worried your MacBook is getting filled up real quick, from the Apple menu, select About this Mac, then Storage, you have a quick summary here. Now click on Manage and voila, you can very easily get rid of what is not required on your Mac and save a ton of space. And if you are interested in more MacBook tips and tricks, check out the playlist on your right or watch what YouTube thinks is best for you on the left. Thanks for watching. My name is Mufaddal. This is Apple Vibes. Take care and I will see you in the next video.